Preparing for the worst, and families in Hauula are praying for the best. People living along Pokiwai's stream are worried about tomorrow's threat of heavy flooding. Brianne Randall joins us with more on tonight's top story. Brianne.
Marissa, it's a constant fear for the folks we talk to, and they are fed up with it. The only problem, a fix to the flooding, may not come soon enough.
When you say rain, the word rings loud in Verna Uli'i's ears.
This is how high it can get.
She lives next to Pokiwai Stream, and every year, this is what happens when it floods.
Oh my gosh, it can change in like in a heartbeat. It just depends on how much rain is falling in the mountain at the time. So yeah, it could change in a matter of minutes.
Sunday's forecast for heavy rain has Verna and her neighbors living on edge.
It's covered my porch. It came with an inch. There's a little step up into my living room as you enter the house. It came within an inch.
As they watch and wait, the city has prepared for the worst, digging a path for excess water to escape.
Depending on how much rain comes, we'll find out if it's worked. It's enough, but clearly the city has made an effort.
Senator Clayton He says the stream is a collective state, city, and community concern. This duck bill valve was added onto a drainage pipe last year to push water out and keep sand from going in. But it was a fix that's proved to be a flop, and so they're taking it out next week.
The reason it's not working is as the wave action pushes sand to the shore, it's burying the duckbill. So the duckbill cannot function and open.
Verna and Judy say removing it can't come soon enough.
At least we're getting help now. But I am concerned about tomorrow.
Without everything working in place, we're going to get flooded again.
They are in talks with the state and city to find a solution to fix the flooding once and for all.
Finally now, they're hope is in the works, maybe some resolution.
Needless to say, a fix won't be found overnight, so Sunday will be a sleepless night for Verna and Judy. Brianne Randall, KHON2 News.
Thank you, Brianne. While it's